In our discussion on health span, I have spoken of several hallmarks of aging that happen at a cellular level. So today I'd like to talk to you about epigenetic modulation or modification that is associated with aging. Aging is associated with a complex interplay of several epigenetic modifications, not just one singular change. These modifications affect how our DNA is packaged and accessed, ultimately influencing gene expression and cellular function. Let me share a couple of examples. So the first is called DNA methylation. This involves adding a methyl group, CH3, to specific sites in our DNA, particularly cytosine bases in CpG dinucleotides. While global DNA methylation often decreases with age, hypermethylation, increased methylation, occurs in specific gene regions, potentially silencing essential genes and contributing to cellular dysfunction and also gene expression. The second mechanism is histone modifications. So histones are proteins that package DNA into chromosomes. DNA is wrapped around these proteins called histones. Modifications like acetylation and methylation on these histones can loosen or tighten the DNA packing, affecting gene accessibility. Age-related changes in histone modifications can lead to inappropriate gene silencing and activation. How do we minimize these changes? While complete prevention might not be feasible, current research suggests some strategies to potentially slow down or mitigate these epigenetic changes. Once again, lifestyle modifications. Maintaining a healthy diet, regular exercise, and adequate sleep can positively influence the epigenome. Dietary factors. Nutrients like vitamins, antioxidants, and specific fatty acids might have beneficial epigenetic effects. So these are emerging interventions, but remember that once again, you know, there are about 10 ways that I propose, they're in my book, Grow Younger, Live Longer, to reverse aging, to actually reverse the biological age. And I'm going to be exploring this in my longevity retreats. And at this moment, we're also looking at how to measure these different markers or hallmarks of aging at the cellular level and create a combination of phytochemicals and nutrients and signal molecules that actually helps facilitate the progression of these hallmarks of aging. So more on this later.